Well, Paul, an uneventful game this afternoon, certainly in the first half, some people thought, but a great result in the end.
Yeah, I think, and credit to Clyde, they come in and then they set out their stall and they make it difficult for you to break them down, and we did find exactly that. I thought we started the game brightly and on the front foot, and they take the sting out of it, goalkeepers' kicks and throw-ins, and they slow everything down, and understandably so, when we want to play at a real tempo and be the opposite and get the ball on the pitch as quick as we can. And again, what I've spoke about previously, take advantage of that full-time training that we get and the preparation towards games, that they don't get that same grace, obviously. So they made it difficult. I just preached at half-time, just be patient. I felt full-backs could have been a bit more progressive, and that's on me a wee bit. I didn't really look into that too much. I felt we could have got forward runs in better areas, and when we made Leon and Gary be a wee bit higher, we're almost attacking with eight players and defending with seven, sorry, and defending with three, with Ben and Dicker and Charlie just being a wee bit more insurance. So I thought that helped us in terms of pinning them back a wee bit more and allowing McGuffey coming inside a threat, Callum on the other side, and allowing runs beyond them. So we were better for that at half time, but it was very much a case of just be patient, and I think when teams come in and set up like that, we're going to have to find that patience, and unfortunately the fans are going to have to find that as well. It's no always going to be up and at them and 100 miles an hour as much as we want it to be, and we want to bring that kind of energy to games. If teams come up and set up in certain ways, we have to find different ways then to break teams down. That's just a matter of fact that it is the way teams come here.
How much was that kind of forward-thinking philosophy part of your thinking when choosing your starting 11? Because we knew Paul Dixon was available again, so we had a suspicion he might come back in, but we really weren't sure what you would do in the midfield with Stephen Hetherington being suspended, whether it would be Seb Ross, who's maybe a bit more forward-thinking, or we thought Ronaldo might come in from the starting 11. What was your thinking behind the choice?
Exactly that. I felt, watching them, I just felt that Seb and Nizzy's energy as a one and a two would have helped us getting beyond, obviously, with Keener dropping into wee areas and them getting in behind. It didn't quite work out that way because of the depth that Clyde played with, and it was a wee bit more difficult to find those spaces. But it was exactly that, just those ones being a wee bit more proactive in forward areas.
In a slightly sort of sense of deja vu, shall we say, a question I didn't think I'd be asking, did you expect such a good goal from Paul Dixon here at the Falkirk Stadium today?
Again, we spoke about getting shots off and that. We had a wee issue with the free kick, actually. We felt that advantage should have been played. It wasn't, and I thank the linesman for no allowing that to go on. And it was brilliant. It really is. When he's winding up on his right foot, I'm not going to lie, I wasn't convinced, but because of the surface and the rain, it was just Dicker's intelligence, game intelligence, keep it on the ground, and almost just passed it into the corner. Brilliant finish.
The second one came fairly quickly afterwards. How key was that in securing the points today?
It's always key when you've got Goodwillie at the top end of the pitch and know how much of a threat he carries. They obviously throw Jones on as well and go a wee bit more direct, so you know you've then got another conundrum to deal with. But it's actually probably more the third goal that's as late as it comes, that's make sure you get that, because 2-0's, granted any score can be precarious at any given time in a game, but 2-0, if you lose that next one, you get a wee bit more edgy than probably you shouldn't be, a la Peterhead a little bit, which was a frustration that we spoke about. So pleasing to get the clean sheet, which was the main thing, but getting the two goals as quick as we did was vital to us, because the longer the game goes on, obviously the fans get a wee bit restless, the players maybe feel that restlessness and become a wee bit more desperate, so it probably was important we scored when we did.
To what extent are you guys aware of the kind of engagement with the fans? Because the fans at the moment seem to be really enjoying the style of football. Do you guys, during a game, pick up on that, or are you just so focused on what's going on the pitch?
From my point of view, probably not. You're just caught up totally in what's happening and the events on the pitch and try to concentrate on that. But I mean, you get a feel for it when you score the goals and things, and the players are over celebrating and amongst them. I think that started at Cove when we got that engagement with them behind the goal, that first goal at Cove. And I mean, we're trying. It's early doors. We'd love them to be with us more often than not. We understand there'll be times that they get frustrated with us. We're a young squad and there's no getting away for that, but up to now they've been excellent for us, and hopefully we can continue to put a brand of football on the pitch that continues to engage them.
A little injury update, if it's okay. We heard midweek that Brad Mackay may be back in contention, and a few of the fans were asking about Ryan Williamson. Can you give us a little update on both, please?
Brad's back training. Probably just a week too early in terms of coming into the squad today, but he'll get a full week's training next week, and then we'll have decisions to make, because the boys have obviously on a run and winning games, so that gives me a wee headache, which is fine. I'm okay with dealing with that. Ryan's, again, building up. Still got a bit of time to go. But he's continuing to improve, which is the most important thing. So hopefully we'll see him back in a jersey not too far away.
And just finally, Paul, all eyes now move towards the game next Saturday, Queen's Park. It's a bit of a dark horse. You seem to be tipped by some for a kind of title shot as well. It's going to be a really tough game, but what's your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously, we've got the advantage of being at home and having the crowd behind us. They're a full-time club like ourselves. They've made some shrewd signings. They've got a good coach, forward-thinking, in Laurie Ellis. So we know it'll be a proper test for us, but one again we'll prepare for from Monday to Saturday, and hopefully come Saturday that we'll have enough to get another 3 points here at Falkirk Stadium.
Here's hoping we can. Paul, as always, thanks for your time.